Good morning friends, I am Vinay. Today I am starting psychometry with the basic term. I want to explain the basic terms. Welcome you all being classes with Vinay at Manavaratna International University. First of all, I want to explain the basic terms which we are using. There is a dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, dew point temperature, specific humidity, relative humidity, enthalpy, sensible heating. First of all, I want to start with the dry bulb temperature. This is dry bulb temperature which is measured by the ordinary thermometer. This is dry bulb temperature. It is measured by the ordinary thermometer in a room. And wet bulb temperature is that temperature when this ordinary thermometer is covered with a cotton piece, wet cotton piece. Then there is a decrease in temperature. This is known as wet bulb depression. There is decrease in temperature. Wet bulb temperature is always lower than the dry bulb temperature. After this, there is a dew point temperature. Dew point temperature is that temperature where the condensation will start at a constant pressure. Whenever we decrease the room temperature at a constant pressure, because room temperature, pressure of the room is constant, at this pressure we are continuously decreasing the temperature. Whenever the condensation will start at this temperature, this is known as a dew point temperature. I will also explain in my next video about TS diagram how this will occur. This is a constant pressure line. At this point the condensation will start. This is a constant pressure line. This one is a constant pressure line. At this point there is a condensation will start. Specific humidity. Specific humidity is that mass of water vapors per kg mass of dry air. This is specific humidity, which is further denoted by capital W. This is relative humidity. It is a moisture content. Partial pressure, relative humidity is a partial pressure of water vapors divided by partial pressure of water vapor in the same volume but at saturation. That means PV upon PVS ya fir MW upon MWS, water vapor at saturation. Mass of water vapor per kg of mass of water vapor saturation, partial pressure of water vapor, partial pressure of water vapor at saturation. This is enthalpy, this is total internal heat energy or a flow in room. This is in form of enthalpy. After this, there is a sensible heating. Sensible heating is that parameter whenever we supplying heat, there is increase in temperature. There is difference in temperature. There is difference in temperature. That means sensible heat will occur. But there is no change in phase. There is no change in phase. That means if there is in a liquid phase, that's liquid is not converted into vapor. But in case of psychometry, we say that water vapors present in air, that is already present in air, but there is increase in temperature of water vapor. But in case of latent heat, whenever we supply heat, there is no change in temperature, but phase change will occur. That's mean water vapor converted into gases or a vapor form. Or vapor are condensed into a liquid form, but there is no change in temperature. That's mean there is a latent heat region. I will also explain all these terms on psychometric chart, because psychometric chart is the most important term in air conditioning. That's why I'm going to use, this is a psychometric chart. This one is a psychometric chart. I will explain all the parameters in this. This is a dry bulb temperature at a constant. This is a measured by the ordinary thermometer. That's mean we will took a point. This is our point. This is our point. I want to explain all the things in terms of this point. That's mean we will have to calculate dry bulb temperature at this point. We will have to move downward. That's mean this temperature is a dry bulb temperature for this condition. That's mean 34 degrees Celsius for this point. If we want to explain wet bulb temperature at this point, we have to move incline. We have to move incline. After this, this is a wet bulb temperature. That's mean 25 degrees Celsius is our wet bulb temperature for the same single point. If you want to calculate the third term, we are using a dew point temperature. Dew point temperature we have to calculate. This we are moving horizontally. We are moving horizontally left side. This point is given as a dew point temperature. That's mean 20 over here, again a vertical line that shows 20 over here. That's mean 20, 21, 22. this is 22 degree Celsius. That's mean dry pulp temperature, outside temperature or a room condition is a 34 degree Celsius. Wet bulb temperature after removing water vapors, this is 25 degree Celsius. At the time of condensation, whenever the condensation will take place, this is a dew point temperature. This is 22 degree Celsius. If you want to find out specific humidity, that means from this point we have to move right side. If we are moving on right side, this is at this point we got specific humidity. This is a moisture content. The moisture content present in per kg of dry air. This is specific humidity, which is denoted by capital W. After this, this is wet bulb temperature line, WBT. This is dry bulb temperature line. This is specific humidity line. This is WBT line. This one is dew point temperature line, at which the condensation will take place at a constant pressure. If we are moving on through wet bulb temperature line, we will cross this line. After this, we will get the enthalpy. At this point, we got the enthalpy. Through this chart, we will get each and every parameters. We will get specific humidity, dry bulb temperature, dew point temperature, wet bulb temperature, and one more thing is a relative humidity. I already explained in this PV upon PVS. This is a relative humidity. The point number fifth is a relative humidity. That is partial pressure of water vapor per kg of partial pressure of water vapors at saturation in the same volume. That's mean this is a relative humidity line. This one is a relative humidity line. If you are able to see the 50% relative humidity, this is relative humidity line. All these are in relative humidity. This is 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. This is 100% relative humidity. This is 100% relative humidity. This is psychometric chart. One more term, there is sensible heat factor we have to calculate. Sensible heat factor is sensible heat upon total heat. If you want to explain sensible heat factor is sensible heat upon total heat. Total heat is in form of sensible heat plus latent heat. This is sensible heat factor we have to calculate. Furthermore, when we solve the numericals of load calculation, I will also explain in further videos load calculation. We will calculate much more higher numericals of load calculation in further videos. So friends, I want to again brief this one. At this point, we have to calculate dry bulb temperature, which is measured by the ordinary thermometer. We are moving downward. We got 34%. If we move horizontally left, we get dew point temperature. This is 22 degree Celsius. If we move inclined, these are inclined lines for wet bulb temperature. If we got this point, at this point we got wet bulb temperature 25 degree Celsius. If we further moving on this side, we got 75 as an enthalpy. At this point, what is the form of enthalpy? It is clear. After this, there is a relative humidity line. This is relative humidity line, which is denoted by phi or RH, relative humidity. We got specific humidity if we moving horizontally on this side. There is a sensible heat factor. I will further explain you about sensible heat factor. This is sensible heat upon total heat, sensible heat plus latent heat. And one more thing I want to explain. These are dotted lines of specific volumes. We have also calculated specific volume in some numericals. These lines are specific volume lines. This is 0.80. 0.85, this is volume, meter cube per kg of dry air, this is 90. That's mean these are the parameters we have to calculate in terms of academic. This is basic psychometric chart. Everyone have to know about this. So thank you friends. We will meet you next time. If you like this video, please share and like this one. Thank you.